We want a Productivity Series controller to control a GS4 Variable Frequency Drive over Modbus RTU. To do that, we just wire the Productivity Controller's RS45 Plus terminal to the drive's SG Plus terminal. And the minus terminal goes to SG minus on the drive, and the ground terminal goes to S ground on the drive. I've already configured the drive for Modbus RTU using this video, so all we have to do is configure the Productivity Series controller. I've already connected to the Productivity PLC, so I'll open the hardware configuration, click on My PLC, and double-click on the CPU. On the Serial Port tab, we need to make sure that the RS45 port protocol matches our RS45 network. The GS drive's defaults are this, so I'll set the CPU to match that for this demo. The rest of this is fine, so I'll hit OK. Great, now we just start writing instructions. Let's create a contact to tell the drive to change speed. And we'll have that issue our Modbus write instruction. We're using the RS45 serial port. We want to talk to the GS4 drive at this node, and let's add a structure for error reporting. We see in the user manual that the RS45 Modbus RTU frequency command is at address 2331, so we put that here. The productivity software automatically prepends the required data that Modbus needs when we tell it what kind of write we're doing. We're writing to a single register, and you can see a 40 appeared up here. And we'll send the value in a tag called frequency data, which we'll set in a data view later. Hit OK, and these tag definitions look fine. Let's copy that wrong and paste it, and change it so that a new tag called forward command enables a Modbus write to tell the drive to run in a forward direction. Drive parameter 928 controls that, and its Modbus address is 2333, so we put that here. We'll send a tag called forward data. Looks like forwards is 0, so we'll set that in a data view too. Let's copy and paste that rung, and create a contact to tell the drive to reverse direction. It's the exact same instruction at the exact same Modbus address, so we just need a tag to send the appropriate data, which again we'll set to a 1 in the data view. Let's copy and paste that and create a run command. The RS45 run command is at address 2332. And let's create a tag to hold the run data, which again we'll set to a 1 in the data view. And we'll copy and paste that to create a stop command. That's at the same Modbus address as the run command, but we'll use a different tag for the stop data. And we'll set that to a 0 in the data view. Well, let's write that to the PLC. I've already created a data view and filled it in with the data needed to execute each command. Again, that came from the parameter descriptions in the GS4 user manual. I'm going to right-click and bring up the data view options, and I'm going to enable this auto edit so I don't have to write each edit individually. Let's set the frequency to 33 Hz and send it via Modbus. Sure enough, the drive got it. Let's change the frequency to 55 Hz and send that. Yep, drive got that too. Let's tell the drive to turn in a forward direction and to start running. And sure enough, it does. Let's reverse the direction of the drive. Yeah, looks good. And let's tell the drive to stop. Perfect. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drive. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free support options. And click here to subscribe to Automation Direct's YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.